Well, to get more on this, and let's talk to Dr. Andrew Fox. Now, he's an expert on Russia from the Henry Jackson Society. Andrew, thanks so much for coming down and joining us on 5 News tonight. I have to say, out of all the statements and of all the things that have been said, I think it's the Police and Crime Commissioner for Wiltshire who's pretty much summed this up in the way that many people are thinking. How could something like this happen on a Sunday afternoon in the quiet cathedral city of Wiltshire? I mean, what do you know so far?
Well, if it does sound like it's something that one might read in a spy thriller, that's precisely because that's exactly what it sounds like. Many people would perhaps assume that if this sort of activity takes place in the UK, then it takes place in London. As your correspondent just said, that's where a lot of Russian money is, that's where a lot of prominent Russian businessmen and businesswomen are based, that's where the Russian embassy is based, that's where one might traditionally think of spycraft taking place in the UK. This case clearly suggests that that is no longer the case if, as the Foreign Secretary was at pains to emphasise, it is the case that Russia was involved in this incident.
So what can you tell us about Sergei Skripal? I mean, he was a former colonel in Russia.
He was. So he was a long-time servant in Russia's military intelligence security. He worked for the GRU, which is one of three aspects of Russia's state security. The other two are the SVR, Foreign Intelligence, and the FSB, the domestic intelligence. He was arrested in 2006, having allegedly sold secrets to MI6 in the 1990s. He was then released from jail in 2010 as part of a spy swap between the US and Russia.
So with that spy swap, then presumably he was pardoned. So how likely is it that the Kremlin is involved in this?
Well, you're quite right. He was pardoned. This wasn't, he didn't, in some senses, give over to the West. He wasn't a traitor in that sense, but it was. He was found guilty in Russia and he was pardoned. I think the timing of this is very interesting. We're 12 days away from Russia's presidential election on March 18th. In some senses, this is very, very bad timing for President Putin. If there's one thing in the West that solidified the idea of Russia being a rogue state, it was the 2006 murder of Alexander Litvinenko. And there are clear parallels that can be drawn between this incident in Salisbury and the murder of Litvinenko in 2006 clearly do an awful lot of damage to Russia's international image.
So fascinating. It'd be really interesting to find out exactly what comes out of the toxicology report, which they're just hopefully going to be releasing soon. But for now, I'm Dr. Andrew Fox, for talking to you.
Thank you.
Now, murder investigation.